Hi, what's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the very last video of Vlogmas 2020. It's been a ride to get here, but I can't believe we are literally on the final day and I have put up 25 videos back to back on YouTube. I think this deserves a round of applause. I'm just gonna wait while you clap for me because oh my god, I did it. And of course, we had to end the roundup of the year with the best makeup of 2020. I think this was a very good year makeup wise personally for me. There are so many products I have over here that I could not shortlist it down when I was like removing makeup for this video. I was like, ye bhi bahut acha tha. So there's a lot of makeup over here with me, but all of this is amazing makeup. And so much of this is like affordable makeup because this year I honestly did not try a lot of high-end makeup. So yeah, I think you will want to know everything that I have over here, but you will also need a snack for this video because it's gonna be a long one. So don't forget to go grab your cola, go grab your coffee, and then let's dive into this. Before that, as always, if this is the first time you've come onto my channel, then please take a moment and hit the subscribe button and join the Sara squad. I make honest beauty reviews and relatable makeup content here on YouTube. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. So the first category is of course primers, and there will be slight repetitions from last year. Not a lot of repetitions, just very bare minimum. I've tried to like hunt down new products only and not give you any repetitions, but if they are in two favorites videos back to back, you can just know how much I love them. And one of them is the Chambord Anti Shine Primer. This primer is genuinely so good. It is a very thick and nice primer which feels very silicone-y, but it's actually silicone free, so it does not clog your pores. It blurs out your pores, makes your makeup look flawless, does not make you like a sweaty throughout the day, and makes your makeup wear really long. That's almost everything I'm asking from my primer, so I really genuinely loved this one this year. Since that was a matte primer, another one of the primers that I have been loving is the Eclat Pro Makeup Primer. Now this was something that towards the like second half of the year I started enjoying. I got it only in the second half of the year, but ever since I got this, I'm unable to like reach out for anything else, even the Chambord one for that matter, because as much as pore minimizing that is, this not only blurs my pores but also makes my skin look really good. And because this is a skincare company making a makeup primer, I think they've done it right when it comes to making it like just as tacky to make your foundation cling, but also like lets your skin get the nourishment and look really dewy and nice. I think personally for me, this was a year of good foundations. Every single foundation I was trying was coming up to be my favorite, and now that I was narrowing it down, I was like, I have loved so many foundations this year. So the first one that absolutely stole my heart has to be the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. Love the finish of this, love the coverage of this, full coverage. The color suits me really well. I'm in the shade Golden Honey. It is like a lot of product for the amount you're paying for this foundation. It comes with a pump. There's absolutely nothing wrong with this foundation. Yes, it can be a little too matte for some people, especially dry skin type. But since I come from the oily skin family, I absolutely love the finish of this. Does not crease, stays on put, does not transfer that much. Everything good about this foundation, and NYX falls somewhere in between drugstore and high-end when it comes to price-wise. So it's, I think, about $1,200-$1,400 for this foundation, but it's definitely worth the money. Next, I think it's a foundation I've fallen back all over in love with, and that is the MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation. I love this foundation so much. It's the foundation I'm wearing right now. I forgot how much I loved it. You know, MAC actually sent this over to me, and back in the day when I started my channel, I only used to use this foundation because I love the finish of it. And also, if you're acne-prone skin, if you have a lot of acne, MAC foundations sit really beautifully and don't irritate your acne that much, which is why I used to use it so much back in the day because I had a serious acne issue. I think when I ran out of my first bottle, I never felt the need to purchase it again. But oh my god, you guys, the coverage, the finish, the longevity of a MAC foundation, absolutely nothing can beat it. I am in the shade NC43.5, and hands down, if you've not tried this one, it's a purchase you should and must make. It's like, save up your money and get yourself this foundation. The last two foundations are pretty affordable. Of course, I had to fall in love this year with the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. De Rai Durust Hai. I have never used the Maybelline Fit Me before, but I think this year was the year I went ahead and bought myself a Maybelline Fit Me, and I loved it. I love the finish of it. 330 Toffee is a shade that suits me very well. Like, absolutely is my skin color, but better. And the coverage is very, very good. Does not emphasize your texture or anything. And lastly, I have loved and enjoyed the Sugar Drop the Base Serum Foundation. This is one of the foundations I literally reach out to on a daily basis. Like, literally, if I have to go down or I just have to go for a mall errand or like a small event, not something that has to make my makeup last very long or make me look really snatched and full coverage, this is the foundation I reach out to. If you're a daily basis basic girl, if you're like a BB cream type of person but you want a little more coverage than BB cream, then this is the foundation for you. It feels like a BB cream and is very lightweight, but it will give you a full blown foundation coverage. So I really like the finish of this foundation, and more often than not I tend to mix this foundation with my other ones because this is like a serum base, so it's more glowy, and all my other foundations are more matte, so I like to like have a combination of both by mixing like one or two drops of this with my matte foundation, and then it gives me the most glowing flawless base ever. For concealers, I have a new favorite and an old favorite. Let's first talk a little bit about my old favorite, which is almost about to get over, and that is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer. I'm in the shade medium deep tan. This concealer is beautiful, you guys. It's so easy to blend. I absolutely love it. It's medium coverage, it's not full, but you can definitely build it up to give you full coverage and looks really beautiful underneath the eyes, to highlight your high points of the face, and also does not crease very much, like absolutely no creasing, minimal to no creasing with this concealer, which I love. I have literally nothing wrong to say about this concealer because it only costs about 300-400 and you can blend it so easily. Matlab, if you're a beginner or even if you're like a pro makeup artist, I think you will love this concealer. And the other one that I absolutely have fallen in love with is the new one, the L'Oreal Infallible Wear Concealer. I just got my hands on this and ever since I've been using it, like I've fallen in love with it. It's the concealer I'm wearing underneath my eyes today and it is stunning. It's full coverage. You need very little to give you that full coverage makeup and does not crease. Again, minimal to no creasing. This concealer also blends like a freaking dream. You're not going to be spending a lot of time doing your base makeup. I have the shade beige and I think it's a perfect highlighting shade for me. Coming to powders, it was again a year of good base makeup, so I have three powders here for y'all. First, let's just get it out of the way that Laura Mercier is going to be a forever favorite. It's never going to run out of any of my favorites video. Every year I'm going to end my favorites video by saying that Laura Mercier translucent setting powder deserves to be in every single girl's makeup kit. It should be your goal point to get a powder that is this flawless, this finely milled, makes your makeup look this airbrushed and literally like a freaking dream, and keeps your makeup on for very, very long. That being out of the way, a powder that I find is very close to the Laura Mercier finish but is in the drugstore category is the Miniso Mini Pony Loose Powder. Again, a very finely milled loose powder, not at all heavy or cakey on your face. Looks flawless and sets your makeup really well in place, and since it's translucent, it dusts off really easily and does not make your makeup too drying. Like, I don't like loose powders that make my skin very dry and then start emphasizing my fine lines. This doesn't do that at all, and I really like the finish of this powder as well. I have the shade 03 Warm Nude. I think they just have three shades in them and this shade is perfect for my skin tone. And then another one of the recent favorites that I've fallen in love with is the K-Beauty Loose Powder. It's a recent launch this year and I have the HD Loose Powder in the shade Latte. It's the powder that I have on my skin right now. You can see how blurred out my skin, my pores and everything look. Also completely minimizes the creasing underneath the eyes. So definitely another winner for 2020. Coming to bronzers, the first favorite is the Ofra Bronzer. I love this one. It's a bronzer I'm wearing right now. You can see what a nice Brazilian bronzy glow it gives me. I love the finish of this. You need very little product for it to make you look like a whole glowing Brazilian bronze tan goddess. Definitely wins my heart in 2020, and I'm saying it's such a glowy bronzer because it does have a, like a shimmer flex to it, which is why it makes your base look even better. But then if you have a lot of textured skin, it might emphasize your texture. So a matte bronzer that I've really loved and enjoyed this year is the Wet n Wild Color Icon Bronzer in the shade Watch Shady Beaches. So if you're anything close to my skin tone, this color is going to be stunning on you. This also has very finely milled shimmer flex in it, but it's so fine that you will literally not notice and does not emphasize any texture on your skin. It's not the bronzer I'm wearing right now, but I have loved and adored this bronzer and used it so much off camera. I think I don't use it that much in my videos as much as I use it off camera. So yeah, I love this one. Blushes, oh my god, blush has become a recent one of my favorites in makeup. I enjoy loading up on blush. Like, I literally go all ham when it comes to blush, and I love the feminine touch it gives my makeup. And the blush that has my heart in 2020, hands down, has to be the Milani Wild Rose Blush. This is the shade Wild Rose, and I think these are called the Rose Powder Blushes. So they have this rose imprinted on them. The packaging is only so stunning and so luxurious. Of course, it is very expensive. It's a 1,050 or 1,200 rupee blush, but it is so beautiful, you guys. So, so stunning. It's the blush I have on right now. It looks beautiful. This shade Wild Rose is a nice peachy pinky blend and complements my skin tone really well. At the same time, it's very long wearing. Like, this is a blush, if I have it on in the morning, it's gonna be on my face till the end of the day as well, and it does not like wear off, which is beautiful and stunning, and I think it's definitely worth it because of that. Since that was an expensive blush, I wanted to give you all an affordable option that I have also really enjoyed this year, and that is the LA Colors Red Rouge Blush, and this is in the shade Awesome. I'm sure there are a lot of more shades for you to choose from, because this is a shade that might not suit everyone, especially if you're very very warm undertone. This might not complement your skin tone because it has a cool grey undertone to it. It's definitely a pinky blush, like a mauve pink, but the mauve undertones, the cool undertones in this are very prominent. I love the formula of this. It's a little powdery, but again very long wearing. About 5 to 6 hours my blush is still there, and very well pigmented. Like, it's not too much in your face, you can slowly build it up. So I love the formula of this one as well. For highlight, I wanted it to be unique, something I've never mentioned in the past. I definitely enjoyed my Maybelline Master Chrome this year, just as I do every single year, but this year I'm also enjoying the K-Beauty highlighters. They were a new launch this year and I went ahead and bought them myself, and this shade Champagne Fizz is so beautiful. It's the highlight on my face right now. You can see what a stunning glow it is. Since it's champagne, it's more universal shade. It's a buildable highlight, so if you just go in with it, it will be subtle, subdued, and not look too much in your face, but you can build it up to give you this kind of a blinding glow, which I love, and also does not emphasize your texture. It's such a finely milled highlighter. Like, oh my god, it's so nice and fine. Oh, it looks beautiful, you guys. I can't even like begin to emphasize how beautiful it is, and that's why it's definitely a winner of 2020. Coming to setting sprays, the first one is the Pat Micro Finish Makeup Fixer. Am I wrong, or was this last year also in my favorites video? Because I love this one. I went ahead and repurchased. This is my second bottle and I love the finish of this. Locks in your makeup really really well, and it's like a deodorant. Like, it's this kind of a nozzle, you know, so I love how it feels, and how it feels makes my makeup set so beautifully. About $8.35 for this bottle, and I really like this one. Next, I have the Maybelline Lasting Fix Setting Spray. Another beautiful formulation of a setting spray. It makes your makeup last really really long, locks in your makeup in place, and I think when it comes to price, this is as low as it goes in setting sprays, which are good, you know. Like, there are even more affordable setting sprays definitely, but this is a good affordable option. Like, this is about $500 if I'm not wrong, and I'm sure Maybelline must go on sale. But the nozzle on this is not my favorite. Like, you have to press really hard for it to give you an even application. But once you do, matlab, you can get past that, and it will give you a distributed amount of product, and it will make your makeup last really, really long. Time for eyeshadows. I think the Morphe X Jaclyn Hill palette will always, it's like a Laura Mercier for me. It's an evergreen palette. This palette is so good, so universal. It has everything you will ever need, right from your neutrals to your bold colors. Do I see this every single year in my video? Because this is such a staple in your makeup kit. If you're a makeup artist, or even if you're a beginner, this is a staple, because it will suit and be loved by so many. Especially the formulation of this Morphe palette is like no other. I have so many other Morphe palettes, but nothing has the kind of blendability and pigmentation that this palette has. Like, every single color in this palette is well formulated. The mattes are good, the shimmers are good, everything is good. And another affordable option that you get in India also stole my heart this year are the Nikaki eyeshadow palettes. I'm only mentioning one right now because this is honestly the one I gravitate the most towards. This is the Poison Apple palette, and it's a warm toned red undertoned shade, so it's very unique to my collection but also right up my alley. I don't have so many nice bright red crimson colors in my collection. This palette has a really good formulation for the price of it. It's only 300 rupees and it blends like a dream. It's a little powdery and you might have a little bit of fallout, but honestly you can't complain with 300 for this. I think when it comes to brows, I've definitely upgraded and graduated from the Mistler eyebrow pencil this year, because this year I fell in love with the Fay Beauty brush. I love this one for my brows. This is in the shade dark brown, and this is supposed to be a brow as well as your regular mascara, but I love it for my brows. It fills my brows as well as locks it in place, so my hairs are like locked in place for a daily glam and everyday thing. And it's also very fast to use. Like, you can't go wrong with this. But if you don't have any brow hair, like if you have nothing and you want like a lot of volume, then something like this is your favorite. This is the one I have right now. This is a Miniso eyebrow pencil. I again love the formulation on this. I love pencils which come with a spoolie on one side, because it makes your job so much simpler. Who the hell is gonna roam with a spoolie on the other side? This is also in the shade dark brown, if I'm not wrong. Yes, I love dark brown for my eyebrows because it looks natural. You don't want to go with black, even though I have jet black hair and jet black eyebrows. I still like to go with dark brown. It just makes it look toned down and natural, and this particular pencil fills in your brows really well and really naturally, and it does not look very waxy. It's a very easy to use product, and I love this one. This year I also fell in love with the Estee Lauder Little Black Eyeliner. It's the eyeliner I'm wearing right now. It's very easy to draw a wing with this, is what I love about this. You have like two sides to this. There's an ultra fine and a thin and thick side, but I love the ultra fine one. It's the perfect felt tip. It has the perfect bend to it, so it just gives you the perfect angle you need for your eyeliner, and also it's very, very pigmented, so you don't have to go way too many times with it. Especially like felt tip eyeliners tend to bleed a lot. When you're doing the wing, it tends to bleed so much that your wing gets messed up in that very place, but this one doesn't bleed at all. It's very long wearing and smudge proof, budge proof. It's of course very expensive, but I think definitely worth the money. For kohls and kajals, I think definitely this year I've only and only used the K-Beauty kohl in the shade Spade. Every single time I was reaching out to this, especially when it comes to kajals, they tend to water my eyes really easily, and this particular kajal doesn't do that, and it's also very pigmented and also very, very affordable. For mascara, I think the mascara that has replaced the Essence Lash Princess is the PAC Big Eyes Mascara, and oh my god, this mascara has stolen my heart. It's only 500 rupees. It comes with two ends, so you have a wand for your lower lashes as well as for your upper lashes, and I love how unique both the wands are. This lower lash wand is something like I've never seen before. It hugs your lower lashes so well, like it is gonna individually coat every single lash. And the brush on this side is also so good. Just look at this wand, it's so nice and thick and fluffy, coats every single one of your lashes, gives you both volume as well as length, which I definitely need because I have very conjoose lashes. Matlab hai hi nahi baal mere lashes pe. So I need something that gives me all the drama possible. So the PAC Big Eyes Mascara definitely takes the award this year. For lip liner, I just have one, and the lip liner that stole my heart this year is a Sugar Lipping on the Edge lip liner in the shade Wooded by Nude. Very beautiful, stunning lip liner shade, and also formula. It glides on so well and it is very, very long wearing. It will make any of your lipstick wear even longer. You can wear this just by itself, and such a stunning, beautiful, beautiful formula. It's about 400, 500 and definitely worth it. And it's the lip liner I have on right now, but I've of course topped it with lipstick. But this is a lip liner of the year for me. And we are finally down to the last category of today's video, and that is lipsticks. It's all our favorite category, and all of us love lipsticks. And these are my favorite lipsticks of 2020. These are the lipsticks I've reached out to the most. So the first one, honestly speaking, that I've used the most this year has to be the Nykaa Matalicious Lip Crayon in the shade Jade Rose. I have two of these and the other one is almost over. I love using this. It's very easy to glide on, so even if I'm going down just to meet my friends, this is a lipstick I just like glide on and go. Easy to wear, a little bit long wearing, and the color is stunning without makeup, which is why I love it. Also with makeup looks really, really beautiful, so I love this one. Next shade that I have used the most is the Maybelline Sensational Matte Liquid Lip in the shade Made Easy. I think every time you'll ask me which lipstick I'm wearing, it had to be this one, because it is again another long wearing formula, and the color is very universal, looks good with as well as without makeup. A very nice, unique nude color, so I love this one as well. Then we have the lipstick that I'm wearing on my lips right now with the Sugar Lip Liner. I have this NYX Lip Lingerie in the shade Exotic on my lips. It's a nice brick reddish nude color, another very universal flattering shade. Does not look very good when I have no makeup on, but with full glam, it looks absolutely stunning, very luxurious and very long wearing. Then we have another nude, which is probably the most affordable nude you will see. That is the Lakme Forever Matte Lipstick in the shade Forever Nude? Nude Dream. Nude Dream. It's a beautiful nude color. Does not look good without makeup, but with glam, it looks really good. Very, very affordable and very long wearing formula. I have reached out to this also very many times this year, so it had to be in this video. Then we have the red lipstick that I've worn the most this year, and that is the MAC Ruby Woo Red Lipstick. Another evergreen color. There's nothing like Ruby Woo and nothing like the formula of a retro matte lipstick. This is, I think, my favorite like lipstick formula overall as well as from MAC. And Ruby Woo is such a stunning color. Like, Ruby Woo is a whole mood, okay? Like, it's not a color that you will... Like, I can't dupe Ruby Woo for you. It has the most unique undertone, and I love how Ruby Woo looks with as well as without makeup, and I've loved and enjoyed this shade this year. And then for my burgundy colors, the burgundy shade that I've loved and almost completely used up is the Smashbox Always On Matte Liquid Lip in the shade Disorderly. It's a very unique sort of a color. It's bold, it's out there, but it's so stunning, especially like on brown skin girls. These colors look really beautiful, and I love this shade and this color, and I've used it a lot of times in my videos. And the other shade that I've loved in this color family is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade Copenhagen. This is another burgundy shade, but it's more toned down than the Disorderly shade. This is a little more wearable as compared to Disorderly, but I love both colors equally. And the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream is more like a moussey everyday formula, whereas the Smashbox one is more long wearing and more matte. Alright, and that completes this video as well as Vlogmas 2020, as well as so close to 2020 overall. overall, this has been a hell of a year. I know there have been a lot of downs more than ups for a lot of y'all, which is why I want to end this year with a very generous giveaway. For today's giveaway, I will be giving away all of this makeup and skincare to one lucky winner. To enter, all you gotta do is be subscribed to my channel, click on the bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below letting me know which was your favorite video from Vlogmas 2020, which was the video you enjoyed the most. And also, along with that comment, don't forget to leave your email address. If you have an Instagram account, then follow me on Instagram and leave your Instagram handle in that comment. And if you don't have, then leave your email address so that it's easy for me to contact you all. All the Christmas giveaway winners will be announced on 28th of December in the Christmas vlog, which will be the final video of the year. I hope you guys enjoyed Vlogmas 2020. I had so much fun these 25 days with y'all. I love y'all so much. Thank you for all your undying support. Thank you for everything that y'all leave such sweet comments in the comment section. I have read your comments every single day, and honestly, that is the fuel to my fire. It keeps me going, and I love y'all so much. I hope y'all have the best Christmas and the best end of the year, and this year closes out on a good, happy note for all of y'all. For today, the Sara Squad shout out is all of you guys, all of y'all who have stayed with me all these 25 days. I love y'all, and I will see y'all finally in my Christmas vlog for this year. I hope you all have a very Merry Christmas. Bye guys, I love you all, and take care.